Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and in this video I'm gonna show you how you can make your composable lifecycle aware. So let's get started without wasting any time. So first question is, what do you mean by lifecycle aware? So lifecycle aware means your composable will know about the views lifecycle, like on create, on start, on resume, on pause, on stop, on destroy. Like these are the views lifecycle event, and we will try to observe the changes in this event in our composable. So first we should know about the lifecycle of our composable. So if you're talking about the composable lifecycle, we are having only three phases: enter the composition, recomposition, and exit the, or you can say leave the composition. So in our first phase, when our Jetpack Compose execute our composable for the first time, it keeps tracks all of our composable. Based on that, it describes the UI, and ultimately it builds a tree data structure. Next, recomposition. When any of the state which present within your composable got updated, it will try to update your composable based on that state change. So due to that reason, it will recompose your tree data structure. Lastly, leave the composition. If your composable is no longer visible to the user, it eventually free up all the resources that your composable occupy. So this is the very simple lifecycle of our composable. Now suppose you have a scenario. You want to refetch all of the information when your application comes to the foreground from background, but that event you can't observe in the composable. So in this scenario, you have to observe those view lifecycle event in your composable to perform that network request call. So let's see how we can do it. So first thing first, you need a project. So just create a project for yourself. And in this, I'm gonna take the reference of our lifecycle owner with the help of local lifecycle owner.current. Next, I'm going to create a disposable effect, and in this disposable effect, my key is lifecycle owner. Now in this, we have a function on dispose. So once your composable leaves the composition, this on dispose block will trigger. Now in this, I'm going to create here lifecycle events with the help of lifecycle event observer. And in this, we have two parameters. First is our source. Next, the event. So when our event, and I'm going to accept the suggestion. So simply press Alt Enter. So here you can see on create, on start, on resume, on pause, on stop, and on destroy. Now it's time to attach this view lifecycle event observer in our composable lifecycle. So for that, on the bottom, I'm using my lifecycle owner that contains my composable lifecycle, and in this, I will attach my observer. So simply use here lifecycle events, and in this, use lifecycle events. Okay. Now our composable lifecycle will know about the views lifecycle, and when our composable leaves the composition, use lifecycle owner dot lifecycle, remove your observer. That's it. Now in this on create, I'm gonna create few lockers to show you the view lifecycle events. So in this, I'm gonna use on create, just stringify this tag. Now simply copy this stuff and paste in every event. All right, so we are done with this. Now at the bottom, I'm going to create a column. Make sure it has a modifier fill max size, and here I'm having a text which says life cycle aware composable. All right, so now it's time to execute this application. Okay, here you can see on create, on start, on resume. Now what will happen if I put my application on the background? See, on pause and on stop will trigger. Now if I just open up my application from the recent tab, see, on start and on resume. So if you want to hit your backend API, you can do that thing very easily in your on start or on resume. It depends on your use case. So yeah, that's it. By using this approach, you can observe the views lifecycle events in your composables. I hope you like this video. Goodbye.